Friends, welcome to your own channel Chakde with Knowledge, and this is interview chapter 3. Let's begin with the revision of chapter 2. So in the chapter 2, we already read about the differences between the debit card and the credit card, what are the advantages of both the cards to the bank and the customers, and what are the disadvantages of the both the cards, and what is the KYC for the banks. Let's begin with the chapter 3 with the KYC documents. Okay. So, Aadhaar card, voter card, driving license, passport, NABARD card, PAN card. These are the few KYC documents and important KYC documents. First 5 are sufficient to open any account, but in case of PAN card, you have to submit an additional proof as address is not available on the PAN card. These proofs provide your address as well as your identity, your photographs to the banks. So these are the KYC documents to identify you, know your customer norms to fulfill. Okay, so next question, what is the financial inclusion? This is an important term in case of Indian banking. Okay, so answer is access to financial product at an affordable cost. What are the financial product? Like saving account, any insurance policy, mutual fund, these are the financial products. At an affordable cost. Affordable means that a poor person can bear. Suppose that if any person want to open an account with 5 rupees, he can afford only 5 rupees, and saving account is available to open for him with a 0 or 5 rupees balance, then this will be called affordable cost. So this is the actual definition of financial inclusion. Access to financial product at an affordable cost. Few financial inclusion schemes. Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. Very important. And others are Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, Atal Pension Yojana, Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana. Okay, we will discuss these in details, but these are the few financial inclusion schemes to include our poor people, disadvantaged people with the financial system. Okay. So next question, what are the measures taken by the government of India for the financial inclusion? Answer is opening of no frill accounts. No frill accounts means zero balance account or minimum balance like 5 rupees, 100 rupees. So opening of no frill. No frill means no charge. Okay. No frill means no charge. Relaxation on know your customer norms. As I already told you, know your customer norms means Aadhaar card, PAN card and other things. Those proofs who proves your identity and address. KYC. So some relaxations are given by the RBI for opening of account of poor pupils like laborers to include them in the financial system. Engagement of BC and BF. BC and BF is business correspondent, business facilitator. What is no frill account? Already discussed. No frill account is with nil or very low minimum balance as well as charges. What is BSBDA? This full form can come in the written exam also. Basic Saving Bank Deposit Account. So friends, the accounts which can be opened by the simplified KYC norms are known as BSBDA account. This is for the financial inclusion purpose. Next question, what is BC and BF model? RBI permitted banks to engage BFs and BCs as intermediaries for providing financial and banking services. Intermediary means between the customer and the banks. BF, as I already discussed, business facilitator, and BC, business correspondent. Now, what is the BC and BF? Okay. So, when you will reply one question, next question will come from the interview panel. BC can accept small deposits and can offer various financial products like Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, small account, BSBDA account to the customer. But BF cannot transact any financial product. They cannot accept deposit. They cannot do any financial transaction. But they are recruited to spread knowledge about the financial products to the public. Work of BF is to provide the banking awareness to the general public. Full form of the BC and BF already told to you. Correspondent, facilitator, both are for the business. Business correspondents, business facilitators. Why bank appoints BC and BF? For the financial inclusion purpose, both are appointed. Benefits of BC or BF model. Reaching the unreached. Reaching the unreached means those people don't have access with the banking channel. Those who cannot access branch, branch is far away from them. So they can contact BC or BF to open their account to get some financial products. Same, second of step, doorstep banking. Doorstep banking means BC or BF will reach to your door and will open account, will provide you financial services. So this is an example of doorstep banking also. Benefits to BC and BF. They are getting salaries from the banks. They are getting commission also from the banks. If they will open lot of accounts, if the transaction is more, they will get the commission also. So friends, here we studied about the BC and BF. We will come again with few some important questions. I request, if you like my video, please hit like on my videos. Please subscribe. Don't forget it. Okay. Chakde. Bye-bye.